Hi, everybody. Hope you've had a good day today. And I hope we pull some fire out of here tonight. Here's what our order looks like for tonight. First up, we have our Innovation Basketball, one box of 2012-13 and one box of 2013-14. Then we have our two boxes of 2012-2013 Limited Basketball. And then we have our eight boxes of Prestige Basketball. And I learned two things about Prestige Basketball. Number one, I have to go a whole lot faster than I did last night in the beginning because, wow, that break takes forever. And number two, I think Prestige Basketball must not be very popular because, that was about a car payment that I think I managed to lose on Prestige Basketball between last night and tonight. So we probably won't be doing any more of that. So anyhow, let's take a look at what's up first. Hi, Michael. So first up, we have 2012-13, 2013-14 Innovation Basketball, one box of each. And you will see, of course, team name down the left and eBay user ID down the right. And a whole bunch that say no bids, buy back. And that just means unloved, unwanted teams staying here with me. Sadly, a lot more of them than I'd like to see tonight on both of our early auctions. But I tell you what, basketball has just been a rough go. I don't know. Maybe it's just because we didn't have a great rookie class or something. Or maybe there's just not as much interest in general in breaking basketball as football. I don't know. But we'll keep trying and see if we can find some products that are fun and interesting. Of course, I've got a bunch up right now already for Prism and Replay and several other things like that. And yeah, so we'll go through that and see how those go. And I guess then that'll help me decide how much more basketball we want to do this year, or if we want to just stick to football and baseball and see what the next rookie class brings for the NBA. I don't know. Oh, and I always forget about this until I see it. All these 2012, 2013 boxes have these, not all of them, but most of them have this extra little pack of cards in it. These little Kobe anthology cards. So since that is a bonus pack of cards, not anything that anybody paid for, what we do is open them. And if there should happen to be a Kobe autograph in here, it will be done as a random to everybody that's in this innovation break. And if it's just base cards, then we don't worry about it because the base cards are very common and nobody ever seems to really want them. And so unless we find a Kobe autograph, nothing's really gonna go anywhere with these. Unless whoever's here watching live, if you're in chat and you want this little set of base cards done as a random, just speak up and I will be more than happy to do that. Most of the time, though, nobody ever seems to really want them even in random, so I don't do anything with them. If anybody's just jumping in, we're doing innovation first, limited second, prestige first, or third. Innovation and limited are both very quick breaks because there's not many cards in either one of those sets. So first up, we have Vince Carter base card for the Dallas Mavericks. James Harden for the Houston Rockets. We have a Dirk Nowitzki. This is going to be one of the stained glass inserts. Looks like it's numbered 100 of 349. Actually, it wasn't the stained glass. I'm sorry. I take that back. This is one of the clear view or glass cards, whatever they referred to them at that point in time. This is our stained glass insert. And that's for the Celtics. And does not look like that one is numbered that I see anyway, but the stained glass cards are really cool, of course. They're one of my favorite things out of innovation. There's a Michael Kidd-Gilchrist rookie for the Charlotte Hornets with our little glass or whatever they called them card. All right, and the rest of these look like are going to be hits. So first up, we have a fine print autograph for the Chicago Bulls, Jay Williams for the Chicago Bulls. And that guy does not appear to be numbered. But there's your hit bulls. We'll set it over here so we can recap it in a minute. Then we have some Tony Parker material here for the San Antonio Spurs, number 39 of 49. So that's a nice low number for our Tony Parker. I'm sure that's game worn. Let's see if it says up there. And it says authentic jersey, but I'm pretty sure that that's going to be game worn. And we'll set that aside. And then we have a redemption. And our redemption is Will Barton, Rookie Innovative Inc. Oh, I should know Will Barton. Was he a trailblazer? We'll have to look him up, and I bet you I stupidly did not carry the iPad up here, which is what I always look that stuff up on, so I'll have to look it up. I see it. I'm going to run down here and grab it so we can look that up. Give me 1 second. I think that's the second time this week I have left the iPad downstairs. I'm telling you what, guys, this just has not been my week. I don't know, I've been all out of sorts all week. Anyway, we're going to look up Will Barton at the end of this break to find out for sure who drafted him in 2012 in the NBA draft. So now we're in our 13-14 innovation. We have a Mike Conley stained glass insert for the Grizzlies. Hey, look at that. We've got some memorabilia, some fabric from Boogie, DeMarcus Cousins. Don't really see a whole lot of his signatures or materials, honestly. Cool little hit for the Kings. And looks like we have a hit here for the Cavs. Probably not the hit you were looking for, but still a nice hit. Top-notch autographs for Spencer Hawes for the Cavaliers. Nice little die cut on top of that. Number 224 of 225. Festus Ezeli. Signature for the Golden State Warriors Foundation, Inc. That's a pretty cool... Is that on card? Yeah, that is. So you got a nice on card signature there of Festus Ezeli on top of that. No little weird sticker. And it's number 13 of 25, so low number on-card signature hit for the Golden State Warriors. And then we have an Otto Porter All-Rookie insert for the Wizards. And then a DeMar DeRozan, number 10 of 10, pretty cool. Another one of our little glass or whatever you want to call it, whatever they called them back then. Insert. So that's a nice low hit for the Raptors. So let me look up Will Barton. I want to say that he was a trailblazer. I think that's who drafted him, but I'm going to pull it up right now and see what I can figure out. And I don't even... Oh, I see that somebody else has said, Michael, you've said Blazers too. Yeah, that's who I thought it was. But you know me, I'm always going to verify it because that's just how I am, right? I mean, these are cards that I'm sending out to you guys. I want to make sure that they go to the right place. And even when I think I know, and even when I'm 99% sure, I still look it up. And I don't even know why, honestly, that I thought that I knew Trailblazers. But for whatever reason, that's what I had in my head. And so hopefully that's going to turn out to be correct. Yep, he was picked number 40. So, see, I'm a little better about remembering who was drafted where in basketball than I am in football, although, truthfully, I'm not always great about remembering either one. So, our hits out of innovation, our redemption for the Trailblazers. I know it's expired. It's okay. Redeem it into your Panini account anyway. Then reach out on Twitter to them and ask them if they still have the card, and if not, what you can replace it with. On-card autograph number 225 for the Golden State Warriors, Festus Ezeli. This is a sticker autograph, Spencer Hawes, for the Cavaliers. That one was number 224 of 225. Our fine print autograph, also a sticker autograph, Jay Williams for the Chicago Bulls. Materials hit for the Kings with Boogie, DeMarcus Cousins. And a materials hit for Tony Parker, Spurs, 39 of 49. And then, of course, we had all of our stained glass inserts and our other inserts over here. So that is it for these two boxes of innovation. So let me set the iPad down, and we'll set these cards over here in our little staging area where they wait to go into their top loaders and sleeves and all that stuff after I sign off tonight. That's the next thing I do, is sit and sort and enter. So now let me get our spreadsheet pulled up here so that we can take a look at break number two. All right, break number two is two boxes of 2012-2013 Panini Limited Basketball. And of course, teams down the right, winning bidder, or teams down the left. Yeah, I used to know my left from my right. Teams down the left, winning bidder down the right. And we have one very popular bidder tonight called No Bid Buyback. Yeah, that would be me. That would be all the ones you guys didn't buy. So, you know, I'm hoping I don't pull very many that go to No Bid Buyback, because, man, I don't want to have to hang on to all those cards. I want to send them out to you guys. I want them to go out in the mail and go bye-bye. That's what I'm hoping for. So I hope everything we pull goes to you guys. We're just going to put that out in the universe and decree that it will be that way. So each one of these boxes is supposed to have two autographs and one memorabilia card. So we're looking for three hits per box, total of six hits in the break, and there will be a total of 14 cards pulled, because each box has seven cards in it, of course. Not quite half, almost half of them are hits. Three hits out of the seven cards. And again, we've got those weird little Kobe packs. And I tell you, I literally forget every time until I see them. So, same as before on the weird Kobe packs, we're going to open them up, and if we find a Kobe autograph, then we will random it off to everyone that is in this break for limited. And if we do not find a Kobe autograph, then all the base cards will just go with the other Kobe base cards. And if someone wants the set of Kobe base cards to be done as a random in this limited break, then please jump in there and chat and let me know that, and I will be happy to do it. But really, only one time has anybody ever asked for that, because, I mean, I think those cards are not really pretty much worth anything. You don't want to say it's not worth anything. It's always worth something to someone who's interested in it or collects it, but they don't have a lot of cash value. We'll put it like that. I think that's probably the better way to say that. Whoops, I dropped our little autograph hit right there on the pack. I forgot out of limited out of this year that they're in these weird little shapes, and so you got to remember to hang on to them. So the first one is for Charlotte. Of course, it says Bobcats on there, but that's okay. It is, you know, the franchise is currently the Charlotte Hornets, so this goes to Charlotte. It is number 77 of 399, Jeff Taylor. And of course, these are on card autographs. So there's our first signature hit. Then next up for the Warriors, we have Jarrett Jack. That's it's basically a base card. Then for the T-Wolves, we have Brandon. Does that say boy or Roy? I'm sure it says Roy. I'm just blind, and to me it looks like it says boy because I'm blind. Then we have Ralph Sampson for the Rockets, a spotlight signature. So there's a blast from the past kind of signature, and that is number 22 of 99 for the Houston Rockets, Ralph Sampson, veteran or throwback signature, however you want to call that. Now, this is a cool thing that's in this series. This little piece here in the middle of the card, it actually spins so that you have, you know, the home jersey on one side and the away jersey on the other. So it's kind of a cool little insert card for the Spurs. So there's, Got Tim Duncan on one side. I guess Tim Duncan actually on both sides, but it's just that's, the back side of the card, that's the front side of the card, and the little piece in the middle spins. So, isn't that fun? I think it's fun anyway. I like it. And who have we here? I don't even know what that says. Ursan Ilisova? Yeah. Okay. Well, it's for the Bucks anyway. Hit for the base card for the Bucks. And then Jason Maxiel or thereabouts for the Pistons. So that was our two signatures. I'm thinking, did I miss a signature? I forgot the little one in the front. Now let's get into our second box. And man, I want to find, who I want to find in here. I want to find Anthony Davis. We need to find some Anthony Davis. So let's vibe for AD. For the Pacers, George Hill, base. Meta World Peace for the Lakers, also known as Ron Artest, before he decided to be Meta World Peace. Center stage, Mark Gasol. That is a fabric hit. And it is number 77 of 199 for the Grizzlies. Bradley Beal, there's a nice little fun little signature for the Wizards. And what is that numbered? Why can I not see what that is numbered? 70 something. 79 of 199. You guys, I'm sure, can see that better than I can. 79 of 199. Bradley Beal for the Washington Wizards. And we've got a redemption. We'll deal with that again in a second. Another base card here, Daniel Gibson for the Cavs. And this is for, I don't know who that is. For the Raptors. Andrea Bargnani. Andrea, probably. Andrea, I'm guessing is how it's pronounced. Glass Cleaners autograph for Drew Gooden in 2012. So let's see. Let's see who Drew Gooden played for in 2012 for the NBA. Does anybody know the answer to that? I do not know the answer to that. While I'm looking it up, if anybody has a guess, feel free to throw it out there in chat because I don't even have a guess. I don't know that at all. So for Drew Gooden, NBA 2012. And let's see what our answer is. You're guessing the Cavs. All right. Well, let's just see. Drew Gooden. Oh man, he played like all over the place. All right, so it looks like he played for Milwaukee in 2012. So he played for Milwaukee in 2010-11, 2011-12, and 2012-13. So that means since this was a 2012 series, that our friend Drew Gooden here is headed there. So yeah, I mean it looks I don't know why I don't know this player, but I'm just double checking to make sure that that is right, but it appears to be. It was on ESPN, the ESPN bio. I didn't see it come up on NBA.com for some reason. It came up on ESPN first, but yeah, that's right, the Bucks. So, our signature's out of limited. We have the redemption going to the Bucks again. It's expired. That's okay. Redeem it into your Panini account. And then reach out to them to find out if they still have it or if they need to substitute something else. Our Bradley Beal numbered to 199 for the Wizards. Our Ralph Sampson spotlight signature for the Rockets. Our Jeff Taylor signature for Charlotte Hornets, or on there it says Bobcats, but same as. And our material hit here for the Grizzlies, Mark Gasol. And our cool little home and away card for the Spurs with Tim Duncan. So that is our 2012 limited basketball. So let's put this over into our staging area, and then we will begin the marathon that is known as 2016-17 Prestige. So if you need a snack, if you need caffeine, anything like that, now would be a good time to go get it because boy, this break takes a while. Even though I'm going to go faster tonight than I did last night, it's still, I mean, it's 8 boxes and there's a lot of cards in every box and it is just going to take us a while no matter how you cut it. So here's who we're looking at in 16-17 Prestige Basketball. We have, of course, again, teams down the left, winning bidders down the right. And there are some new faces in here for sure. So welcome to all you folks who are breaking with me for the first time. I'm glad to have you. And of course, always welcome back to everyone who breaks with me on a regular basis. Hopefully some of you will also start breaking with me more often. I'd love to have more people in basketball because I enjoy breaking basketball. I just don't do very well with it, so it makes it hard to do it very much when you lose a ton of money on it every time you break it. So, I don't mind as long as, if I break even, that's fine. Even sometimes if I lose a little bit, that's fine. But man, when you start losing in the hundreds of dollars, it makes it tough to keep going with basketball on a regular basis when you just don't get a lot of interest in it. And again, maybe that's just the rookie class this year. I mean, we certainly have some good rookies this year, but maybe nobody that everybody's as excited about as they were last year over Karl Anthony and some of those folks. So here's what we're going to do, guys. We're just going to blow through this, all right? So last night in the beginning, I kind of paused on things for a bit to let people get a better look at it, and then I realized about halfway through that it was going to take us the rest of our natural lives plus one day. So we started going a lot faster, and even when we started going a lot faster, it still took a very, very long time. So we're just busting through it tonight. If there is something that you see go by and you think, hey, I need to take another look at that, I want to see that again, just throw it up there in chat and I will, grab it back and hold it back up there for you. But in the absence of seeing that, we're just gonna bust and go, bust and go. Because, man, I don't even know what time it was when we got finished last night, but it was late. It took forever. All right, so we have a Preeminent Ink hit numbered to 199 for the Rockets. That is Chucky Brown for the Rockets. And that is a sticker auto. Where are we going to set this? Because we'll set our, let's move our pile of base over slightly this direction. And then we'll set our hits right here. And that way we can go back and recap our hits at the end. Provided I don't do anything dumb like accidentally mix them in with the base. Actually, that's not a good place for it either. Let's move it here. And then, yeah. Sorry. I'm just trying to find the way that is like the most natural way to do this. I think they call these metallicized or metallized. They have some strange name for them in this set, but they're inserts. They're not numbered, but they do have that special little finish on it. So when you see one go by that has that shiny finish, that's what that is. Any Ben Simmons cards? There will be Ben Simmons cards. There will be about 9,000 Ben Simmons rookie cards in here, more than likely. I mean, just base cards. Of course, if we get any hits or anything, obviously, we'll pull those out. If I see any special inserts, I'll make an effort to grab that too. So here's a hit for the Bucks. This is our second signature hit out of this box. And of course, that's Malcolm Brogdon for the Milwaukee Bucks. So now we're just looking for one materials hit in here. Because there's two signatures and one material and on average. All right, so now when you were asking about specifically about Ben Simmons, I mean, did you want me to stop on every time we see one of his rookie cards, or you just mean if there's an insert that says Ben Simmons, or can you tell me, Thomas, exactly what you're looking for there? Because there really will be a bunch of just his base rookie cards in here if it's anything like last night. I mean, there were, I don't even know how many there were last night. There were a lot. Yeah, the Brogdon was a nice autograph hit for sure. Nice hit for the Bucks. Last night, you mean you saw you saw five what last night? Oh, of his rookie cards? Oh, I don't know. I thought I saw more than that. I sorted today, and maybe there were only five, but it felt like there were about 500, but then again, I was breaking up 8 boxes worth of cards, so I sorted probably close to 1,000 cards today just from Prestige alone. So maybe that is why it felt like a lot more than that to me. I don't know. But yeah, so I will, if you literally want, every one, I will try to pay better attention because most of the time I don't really pay attention to who's on the base cards. I'll just be real blunt when they're this heavy and we're just trying to bust through them. I very seldom actually look at it and pay much attention to it. But I do remember on Ben Simmons in particular, it'll stand out a little bit because the background is, just solid black. It doesn't have people or other action in it because, of course, he's injured. So it was done, I'm sure, in some kind of, photo shoot, like in a studio or something. So the background of it looks completely different than any of the other cards. So that's one way that you'll be able, and I will be able to pick it out a little more readily, even when we go quickly, because it looks different in the background than anybody else's rookie out of this set. This is a little bonus shots insert. That is numbered, well, I think I had it the right the first time, 64 of 75 on that insert. And there'll be a handful of those bonus shots in here. I don't even know if it's one per box, but there will definitely be a few bonus shots in here. There were a couple last night that were numbered, it's either to 5 or to 10 of the bonus shots. So yeah, I did promise you guys last night that we would go faster tonight because last night was, I mean, I almost fell asleep myself last night, right? I mean, that just took forever. So long. So we're making a little better progress tonight, hopefully, than we did last night. And then after each box, I'll just have to kind of set our stuff off, set the big stack of base off to the side so that I don't, get it so high, we don't want it to topple over on us or anything. And last night we pulled several Panini points cards as well, and every time we pulled a Panini point card, it replaced one of our autograph cards in that box. So I hope that we do not have that continuing on tonight. Of course, you never know, but I hope that we don't have too many of those tonight. I'm not a fan of Panini replacing what should be our hits with Panini reward point cards. I don't think probably too many people are a fan of that, actually. I don't really even know why they do it, but they do. All right, so somewhere in one of these last two packs, we should have a material hit, but these boxes should each have 3 hits in them. And we've only pulled 2 out of this box so far. And there it is, speak of the devil. Number 61 of 199, Goran Dragic for the Heat is our materials hit. And see how the background is of this guy of Anunoby. That's how the background will look for Ben Simmons' rookie card, too. Just the black kind of curtain in the background. that'll help you see it when it flashes by. All right, let me move this stack of base cards over here out of our way so that we can spread out and make a new pile. I'll tell you what, let's move our hits pile somewhere, because I don't know, they're just not very convenient where they are right now. So maybe that's going to be better. We'll find out in a second. Prestigious. All these boxes are taking up more space on my table than I'm used to, so I don't have quite the same work area that I normally have. So I'm having trouble figuring out where to set things that don't either get in my way or in the way of the camera or whatever. All right, empty box number is number two that we are starting on. Box number two right now. All right, so let's put. All right, we're going to put our, maybe that'll work. We'll try it right there for now and see what that does for us. All righty. Another one of the little metal or metallicized or metal. I think they call them metallized. I mean, it's some word that you look at and think, why did you call it that? Like, it's a strange... It's a strange thing that they call the cards with that finish on them out of this set. So if anybody does, I think the SEC tournament games are still on right now. If anybody happens to have the SEC tournament on your television or whatever you might be watching, and you want to throw a score into chat, I would not be a sad person if you did that. Of course, Kentucky plays tomorrow, but I do kind of like to keep up with scores and things anyway. We did have some case hits last night, too. And you know, it said we were only, it falls an average of one per case, but we definitely had more than one case hit last night, for sure. We had like three or four. So, I don't know. I guess maybe I was just mistaken about it being one per case. I don't know. But I know for sure we had two prestigious picks, because one was Scalabissier out of, for Sacramento from Kentucky College wise, and our other one was for the Phoenix Suns. So we definitely had had at least two of those, and then we had something else that was a case hit. At least one other thing that was a case hit last night, maybe two. So I must have been, maybe I was just wrong about how many there are per case. I thought it said one, but. This is 181 of 199. 181 of 199 materials hit for the Heat, Justice Winslow. And that's what the back of that looks like, true colors. And speaking of Duke, although, you know, Justice Winslow reminded me of Duke. Duke knocked Louisville out of the ACC tournament today in the quarterfinals. So that didn't make me sad, gotta tell you. You know, I'm not a, even though they're from Kentucky, they're down the road from us. Yeah, they're our big time rivals, especially now that Patino coaches, you know, when he went down there, that really just did it. So, yeah, anytime Duke and Louisville play, I have a hard time trying to decide who I want to win. I know, it's awful. College basketball rivalry is so terrible. We should just be happy they're from our same state. But it's like Duke and North Carolina, right? I mean, they would just like battle to the death, I think, if you let them. They would do a Hunger Games battle to the death. So I think it's just part of college ball, right? I mean, you just get... get those rivalries going, and then you got to stick with them. We had one hard court heroes that was numbered to, I think it was 25 last night as well. So there are a lot of inserts in this particular series. Handful of them are numbered. But I probably, yeah, I don't think I'll break this set again. Well, I definitely won't break 16, 17 of this again. No. We might still look at some of the older past years or something, because as a series, I mean, I like Prestige as a whole, and you can find some cool things in it, especially when you get the passport autographs for the rookies. Those are some of my favorites. But it's not, I guess, apparently not very popular. Yeah, you want some one of ones. Yeah, I'm telling you, man, we have yeah, yes, well, yes, Ray, I do wish this was that this was a little less base intensive, but you know what I was talking about last night, one of the reasons, part of the reason that I do this set, not only because I do like some of the things in it, like the rookie passports and things like that. Was this going to be? Yes, nice. Nice. Buddy Hield for the Pelicans. Of course, he's been traded away now, but he was still a Pelican when he signed this card. So there you go. Nice hit, New Orleans. Anyway, one of the reasons, another reason that I did Prestige is, you know, sometimes you have to do some sets like this when you want to get some of the other stuff. And I want to do a case or two of Select Basketball for this year. And you know, part of the way that you get there is it's all allocated. So if you want to get some of that kind of stuff, sometimes you have to buy some things that are base card heavy and stuff like that. But even so, again, I mean, there are things about this set that I like. I just having it to do over, I would not have probably done a half case at a time because 8 boxes is a tremendous amount to set and do. I would probably have done 4 boxes at a time and done 4 different breaks, and that would have been smarter. But, you know, live and learn, right? So, oh, you were asking me the number for Buddy Hield? Yeah, sorry. Can you catch it there on the corner? It's really hard to get it in a right light. It's 4 of 10, and sometimes it'll show up and sometimes it won't, but can you see it? Well, not really. There, now you can. I mean, I realize it's not facing forward, but at least the light's at the right angle. It's right down there in the light cloud. So yeah, it's 4 of 10. So it was a nice hit for the Pelicans for sure. And that's what I'm saying. There are nice hits in this set, but for whatever reason, people just don't appreciate this set very much. So, for the Hawks, we have Mike Muscala, numbered to 199 for the Hawks as our second signature there. And that is the end of box number 2. So let me get the base stack out of the way for these guys for box number 2, and then we'll bust into box number 3. But yeah, so I'm hoping that, you know, I'll be able to get a couple of cases of Select Basketball, and obviously I hope that it does a little better than some of the other basketball has done. And I was trying to get quite a bit of Optic Basketball too, but I'm rethinking that a little bit now because Optic is it's got a lot of base cards in it as well. It's of course a different series than Prestige, and I don't know if it would have more interest than Prestige or not. But I'm also not keen to buy a bunch of it and then end up, you know, losing a bunch of money again. So I'm not sure if I'm what I'm going to do with Optic. Well, yeah, Optic is supposed to be hot this year, but I got to tell you, there's been no basketball all year that I think has done worth a diddle for 16, 17. I mean, nothing that you break has been that anybody breaks has been particularly good for 16, 17, in my opinion. So I don't know. We'll see. I'll have some mosaic here. I think it's maybe next week gonna be here. We'll see how mosaic does. I mean, that'll make a difference too, of course, because I've got a case of that coming. We've got to bust through that case of replay this week. Of course, that's 1516. That's not 1617, but mosaic is 1617. Yeah, I mean, I have an order in for optic, but again, it's allocated, so we'll see how it. First of all, we'll see whether or not I get everything that I've asked for both optic and select. Just because I asked for it and order it doesn't mean they'll give it to me. And sometimes even then, they'll tell you you're going to get it, and then it comes up to release date, and they'll change it up and say no, you don't get it, or you get less. So we'll see if I get it or if I don't. And we'll go from there, I guess. And hopefully we will be able to have some fun with that. And mosaic is going to be really cool. I'm actually very excited about mosaic because, of course, it's not just for sale out in the general world. It came from buying replay. So you had to buy replay to get mosaic. And of course, mosaic being is going to be a type of prism, but a very limited prism. Oh, sweet. Now, there you go. There's another nice hit. Now, you know I love him because, well, yeah, he went to UK. So, Denver Nuggets, nice hit with Jamal Murray's signature. Very nice indeed. Does not appear to be numbered that I'm seeing for Jamal, but still, I think you should be happy with that. I'm happy with that. I hope you are, Nuggets fan. Happy with Jamal Murray. So. So, yeah, this is what I'm saying, Ray. I mean, there's some good stuff that comes out of here. And I just really did not imagine that it would do as poorly as it did, especially tonight. I mean, last night was not good, but tonight, of course, was far, far worse. So I was really kind of surprised that it did as badly as it did. But, you know, it happens. Darren Williams, materials hit for the Mavericks. I don't think I saw a number on that. Now, or he may say Deron. I called him Darren, but it's really probably Deron Williams, technically, very strictly speaking. Oops. I almost went right past our bonus shot, didn't I? This one is also going to be numbered to 75, 26 of 75, I think that says. You can catch it when I get the light turned just right on it and we get the reflection off of it. You can see it. Yes, and I thank you for joining into the break too, Ray. I always appreciate everybody breaking with me. There's a Ben Simmons, Thomas. Because I enjoy doing this. I mean, there's another Ben Simmons. This one is an insert, of course, reminiscent, and they're saying he's reminds them or reminiscent of Blake Griffin with the Clippers. So that's Blake Griffin over there. And there's Ben Simmons. So yeah, I always appreciate everybody that breaks with me because it's fun. I like to do it. I enjoy it. I like buying into breaks. I like doing breaks. I like cards in general. I like sports. It's for me, it's all fun. So I always appreciate everybody who spends their time and their money with me. Yeah, see, I figured, Thomas, if you were sleeping or something, you know, if I said your name, I might wake you up. If you like dozed off there, you're like, yeah. You're not even halfway through. I'm taking a nap. I've gone on to gone outside. Walked around the block, come back. I feel you. It is a slow, painful process. It's like childbirth. You have to forget how terribly painful it is before you're willing to do it again. Kyle Wilcher also played for Kentucky for a while before he went to Gonzaga, and he is for the Houston Rockets. And I don't believe Kyle is numbered either. Don't see a number on him. So, hit for the Rockets with Mr. Kyle Wilcher. I haven't seen any stats on him anyway. How's is he still? I mean, what's his deal? Is he playing any? What's going on with Kyle? I haven't heard anything at all about him. I keep up with a lot of my UK guys, but of course, you know, he went away. He left for the bag, so I followed him still some, but we don't get as much news on him here, you know, when he's moved on and start playing somewhere else. Oh, you didn't expect to see Kyle Wilcher's autograph in there? Yeah, well, I mean, you know, it's always a mix of the rookies. It's not always just the high-profile rookies. You get a little bit of both, but Prestige does have a tendency to lean towards the higher-profile rookies in general. You're right, but there certainly are some that are a lower profile in here as well. And you know, sometimes you find some veteran signatures and things in here too, obviously. It's not all rookie signatures in here, but I think there's a Bryce Johnson. I had a bunch of Bryce Johnson last night too. In fact, we had two Bryce Johnson autographs come out last night. But I think Prestige does have a fair amount of rookie content. But what I'm really excited about is to get into, I think it's tomorrow night, the other half of that encased football. Holy Moses. I mean, when we opened the first pack out of the first box and it was the DAC to 75, graded 9.5 for the card and 10 for the auto, I was like, yes, I'm in love with this product. And I wish I had ordered more because can't get any more now. The only place you can buy it now is vastly inflated prices, and it was pretty darn expensive to begin with, which is why I didn't buy more. I was afraid to dip into it very deeply, you know, being a brand new product, and it looked nice, but sometimes they look like they're going to be great, and then you break them, and it's like, oh my gosh, what has happened? But no, encased was, oh my gosh, so nice. Like every card I pulled out of there, I was just thinking, man, I would love to have that card. So tonight, before I came in here to do this, I put in a bunch of bids on various breaks. But of course, since I'm not there to watch them, I'll probably end up getting outbid. But on the off chance that I don't, you know, I tried to buy into some encased, and I tried to buy into some select football, because that's another one I did not get a full case of. I just didn't get it in the allocation. All I got were some individual boxes, and so I'm just going to break those one at a time. The select football, I mean. Which product scares you? You had a lot of 8.5s. Oh, I don't know. I mean, my encased was, I don't know if, I don't think I had any 8.5s in encased. If I did, it wasn't more than one. We had nines, and we had the DAC was 9.5. I had some cap patch. I had a couple of cap patches, and I think they were to nine. I might have had an 8.5, but I didn't have much of it. You'll have to, I mean, the break is posted on there. I guess it was just last night. To see how it all runs together when you go through this much base cards, it's like it seems like it was last week. But yeah, I broke it last night when it came out. So if you look back on the video, which is on YouTube, you can see what we pulled out of there. And honestly, I was really happy with pretty much everything we pulled out of there. I had a Kenyon Drake, I think that was to 10. I mean, everything is on card autos. It's rookie heavy. It was nice. So anyway. Yeah, I'm excited to get into select football too. I tried really hard to get. Whoops, this is a bonus shot, probably numbered to 10. No, it's numbered to 5, 2 of 5 on this particular bonus shot. So there's that. Yeah, I'm excited to get into select football too. I wish I had been able to get more. But I listed all the teams, but I didn't list the exchange rookie. I'm keeping the exchange rookie out of the select boxes that I did get because, you know, I didn't want to list them and sell them. I wanted to keep the exchange rookie cards, but all the team hits and everything will be listed like normal. So I don't know. I mean, maybe there were a lot of other 8.5s and other people's encased. I mean, I can't say one way or the other because I haven't seen anyone else's break. I just know my break. I was really happy with what we pulled and our graded stuff. Maybe we had one that was graded lower like that, but I'd say the majority of our stuff was 9, and the DAC auto was to 10. So the card itself was 9.5 and the auto was to 10. And I love the Cat Patch autos. There's another Ben Simmons Thomas base rookie. Hey, there's a speaking of a veteran and not a rookie, here's a Paul Gasol autograph numbered 249 hit for the Spurs. So that's cool, little hit for the Spurs. And I swear to you, it happens without fail, right? Like, everybody knows that this is the time of night. Everybody knows this is the time of night when I'm breaking cards. But you know what? They just call, and then you guys hear the phone ring. And you know I'm old school then because I still have a home phone. But what are you going to do? At least I remembered tonight to set it, you know, next to me so I didn't have to run across the house to get it and stop it from ringing like I sometimes do. But of course, I already had to jog downstairs and get the iPad. So you guys give me my exercise because my poor memory. I don't remember to bring the phone. I don't remember to bring the iPad. Although I remembered one of the two tonight. So I guess that's progress. Remembered the phone, did not remember the iPad. So anyway, what are you going to do? And that was because I left it off the hook. So obviously I didn't answer it, you know? I mean, I answered it so it stopped ringing, but clearly I did not talk to the person on the other end. Don't even know who it was. I just hit on and then set it in the floor. Figured, well, they'll hear me talking, realize that, yeah, they forgot I would be on a break, and then they'll just hang up. So, I don't know. I don't think you should be afraid of encased, though. I really don't. I've been really... What we pulled anyway, I thought was awesome. Now, maybe I'll open the second half tomorrow night and change my mind. But based on what I saw last night, I love it. And I'm trying to buy into other people's breaks. So, that's how I feel about it. And select, of course, is always good. And I particularly, you know, I'm after the little exchange rookie cards. So... That's why I didn't list them. I might list it for the last box or two that I have of it. I don't know. But the first couple boxes, for sure, I'm going to keep that out of it. I never keep whole teams because I just don't do that. When I break, I just sell them. But that little card I want for whatever reason. What teams do I buy myself? Well, if I am buying football, I usually go for the Steelers if I want it myself, you know, for my personal collection. I collect Steelers. And occasionally I will go for another team if there's a rookie in it or a veteran in it that I think I'm likely to hit that I collect, you know, because anybody that went to UK and then went pro, like, for instance, Randall Cobb at Green Bay. You know, we've got some other good players at other places in the league. We just don't have a lot of them in the NFL. So I tend to go primarily with the Steelers if it's for my own collection. If I'm just looking to get some rookie cards that I think, you know, maybe I can get graded and do something with later down the road, depends on any given break or any given year. I mean, this year I would probably be after, of course, the same as everybody else. I'd be looking at the Chargers. You'd be looking at the Cowboys. I mean, I honestly would, you know, I've put in some bids for the Chiefs, too. I think the Chiefs have between Tyreek Hill and DeMarcus Robinson. I mean, I think the Chiefs have some good potential hits, and they don't generally bring a lot of money in a break for whatever reason. And then, of course, basketball, I'm all over the map because I'm looking for my former UK players, and we're just all over the place. Our players are on so many teams in the league that I've been in all over the place for basketball. Oh, here's our true colors hit here, Bradley Beal, also numbered to 199. I think all of these true colors are actually numbered to 199 because I think all the ones last night were too. I don't remember seeing any that were numbered lower than that. Or they may have been, and I can't remember it. When I'm doing this, do you guys see the full card? Like I watch this on two devices. One device that shows it to me in real time. The second device is what I have to look at when I want to see chat, and to make sure that things aren't stalling or giving you problems, on YouTube. And on the primary device, everything, I see the full card, no problem. When I look on the secondary device, I see sometimes it looks like the top or the bottom of the card is cut off. So you see it fine on yours. Okay, good. So it's probably just that it's smaller on that one because I have the chat window open there so that I can keep an eye. We're going back to that so that I can keep an eye on what you guys are saying. Yeah, I just set that down because there were only two more cards in my hand. I don't know this player for the Jazz. Joel Belomboy? Belomboy? I don't know. You know I can't pronounce names. I don't know if that's a good hit or not, guys, because I don't know this player. It is a hit for the Jazz. I do not know if it is a good hit or not. Of course, any hit is a good hit, but you know what I mean. I don't know if it's a high value target for the Jazz. So if our Jazz team owner is in there, let me know if that's a good, a bad, a what is that guy? If anybody knows. I'm thankful that we have not seen any. Well, I'm not even going to say it out loud. Why even put it in the universe? Yeah, so far I'm happy with the break. We'll leave it at that. Why tempt fate, right? He's a Weber State alum. Okay. He's not getting a lot of playing time. Okay. I just didn't really, I mean, I didn't even recognize his name at all, even from the college scene. So I don't know how I missed that guy, but somehow I did. So there you go. So nobody's watching the SEC tournament, huh? Okay. Well, I don't even remember who's playing tonight, so I don't think that's probably too bad that I'm missing it. UK is tomorrow at 1 o'clock. And I think we play Georgia, right? Georgia beat Tennessee, so that would mean I believe we will have Georgia tomorrow. And tell you what, we've been so inconsistent this year. Be interesting to see how things go. I don't know. A little scary to be at that kind of place where we are right now, headed into March, does not really thrill me. Sure, it doesn't thrill Cal either, but what are you gonna do? But I'll tell you right now who's going to be the hot rookie next year, or one of them anyway, is going to be Malik Monk. I don't know if you guys have seen that kid play, but man, he can light it up. I mean, De'Aaron Fox is a heck of a guard too, and I think De'Aaron will also do very well, but Malik Monk, man, that kid is something else. If he gets going, I mean, he can light you up for 40 or 50 points and without you even realizing that anything has happened. He is crazy good, but he's also very streaky. What does that say? 35 of 75 down there in the corner. 35 of 75 for that insert, bonus shots insert. But that's the one. Obviously not the only one, but that's one of our UK players that I'll be keeping an eye on that I think we'll might have some high hopes for next year in the pros. Well, of course the draft this year, but Julius Randle, man, they got to get the Lakers straightened out too. Oy. Man, that's been a hot mess down there. Now that Jeannie fired her brother and brought in magic and all that. We'll see how that shakes out. But of course, then I guess two of her brothers banded together and they were going to try to sue her and get her removed. And I don't know. And then I guess they decided to back away from that plan and leave her alone for the time being. But, you know, I mean, her dad's the one who left her in charge. He's the one who said she should be running the team. So, I mean, the man wasn't like rich and successful for nothing, so I have to assume that he knew what he was doing. But that team is a mess. Course, they're not the only ones. There are lots of teams right now that need a little help. Well, how about that? There's another veteran autograph in there, and it's for the Lakers, no less. This one numbered to, does that say 99? I believe it does say 99. So we've had a couple of preeminent ink in here, which is nice. And for the Lakers, I'm sorry, Laker card. I didn't mean to talk bad about your team. Your team's gonna get better. Of course, he doesn't play there now, but nonetheless, now I feel kind of bad for smack talking the Lakers. Ooh, thank you for the score, Thomas. Ole Miss 63, Missouri 48. Ooh, Missouri getting killed. Wow, yeah, they are getting lit up, aren't they? Is it second half, I guess? Don't know. I don't even know who I think's going to win the tournament this year. I haven't even gotten that far. And Kansas, man, they've got some good players, but good grief, every other day one of them's getting arrested for something. Kansas is having a hard time. Second half, 12:42. Thank you so much. I appreciate that update very, very much, Thomas. Very much. I like being able to at least have a handle on what's going on. But I know if I tried to set up in front of the television that I would just be way too distracted and I would be watching the television more than I should. So I don't even set up in front of the TV. I set up in a place where I can't see anything but the cards, so that I cannot possibly sidetrack myself with any scores or anything. Isn't that awful? I have to isolate myself to make sure I'm not watching the scores. Yeah, I know. It's terrible. It's terrible, terrible. But really, here's another Ben Simmons reminiscent insert, Thomas. But you know, you can't really be from Kentucky, I don't think, and not be into basketball. At the very least, basketball and probably horse racing. You know, football's a little dicier given our record, but we're coming along, man. Football, we're gonna be pretty good. We're getting there. We're not gonna be at least in the bottom of the basement. We may not be Alabama, but we're not gonna be well, I guess Kentucky would have usually been the one in the bottom of the league, so we're not gonna be Alabama, but I don't think we're gonna be typical Kentucky either. I think we're gonna be better than that. Is this an extra autograph in this box? Am I just crazy? I guess not. I guess the other one came out of the other box. Not the Laker, but the one before that. CJ McCollum to 199 for the Trailblazers. So Portland's got a little ink, stars of the NBA. So we're hitting as much veteran as we are rookie right now, which is kind of a nice little change of pace. A little unusual to hit that much veteran and prestige, but I'm happy for it because that makes it a little more fun for us all. Ole Miss looks good compared to Missouri. Yeah, SEC basketball has been less than stellar in recent years in many regards, but they're also making good progress. You know, we've got some good coaches in place. The recruiting is starting to go well, and I think the SEC as a whole is gonna come up in the next year or two, back closer to what we used to be. When we had several powerhouse teams in the conference. So, I mean, I don't want Kentucky to be the only powerhouse team in the SEC. I mean, sure, I like to win, but I like the conference to do well. Gotta have pride in our conference schools too, right? Thon Maker. I don't see a whole lot of Thon Maker coming out of here. I'm not sure Thon has produced quite to the level that they thought he would yet, but I still think he's got a very bright future ahead of him. I'm not saying he's playing badly, but, or, you know, I just don't think he's quite as much as maybe we originally thought that he would be right off the bat. But there's an adjustment period, you know, there's a learning curve. Freshman fabrics for Wade Baldwin for the Grizzlies. Ha, huh, there's one numbered to 99, so 94 of 99, so not all materials are to 199. Because Mr. Wade Baldwin is to flat 99, no one in front of it. And let's move this giant stack of base cards out of the way. Look at how fast we're blazing through this compared to last night. We're already on box, I don't know what this is, six. Six of eight. Six of eight. We are just burning through it. That's what I should have done last night too, I guess, from the beginning. But in the, you know, when you first open something, I kind of like to look at the inserts in the base and things for a little bit longer just to see what you've got. But when you have this many cards, I guess it's really probably not very practical. Do you know how when you buy a new car, there's like new car smell? This is the cards, when you open them, also have a very distinctive, like, new trading card smell. And I find myself on days that I don't do breaks, which recently I've been doing breaks almost every day, but on the days when I don't do breaks, I sometimes find myself like thinking, oh, I miss the new card smell. It's so weird, I know. I never claim to not be strange in that regard. Well, in any regard, who am I kidding? Yeah. My mother would probably be kind and call it unique. But, yeah, it's probably strange to miss the new card trading smell on the days that you don't open them. Ooh, is that going to be a signature? Oh, sweet. Sweet. John Stockton to 199, old school signatures. Yay for the Jazz. Jazz, I hope that you like your old school player, okay? Because first of all, I love John Stockton. But secondly, I really like the old school signatures in this set. And we pulled a John Stockton materials hit last night. And when I flipped it over, I thought, man, wouldn't it have been nice to have had a John Stockton auto? And there it is. So, Jazz, I hope that you like that card, because I like it. Yeah, John Stockton rules. He was a great player. Great, great player. And, frankly, I like it when they go back and include some of our great players from past years in these sets. I know some people do not feel that way. They like to only have the current players and the rookies, and they don't really care about the, I will call them, historical players. But I like the veterans, especially when they're big-name veterans like John Stockton. I enjoy seeing them included in the set, and I enjoy, you know, if I'm in a break, I like to pull them for my own collection as well. In fact, I often go onto eBay and buy cards for, you know, veterans who have been out of the league for a few years, and you can pick them up a lot of times for not much money. People just aren't as interested in them once they're out of the league, but I still enjoy them. So I buy them on there as individual cards fairly often, actually. Another distinctive ink, Alan Kreb or Krebby, for the Trailblazers, and that's one of those signatures that you just go, what? I mean, look at that. It's an A and a C. Come on, guy. You got paid to sign that. 92 of 199. And all you're gonna do is put an A and a C, but all right, bud, we'll take it because that's what you gave us. Julius Randle. It's too bad he broke his leg that first year with the Lakers. I think it really just kind of messed up his whole mojo. But they've got the pieces there to do, they've got the right young players there. I think they need to mix in a little experience with the younger players and get themselves kind of back on track. Because I like the Lakers, so I want the Lakers to generally do well. They're one of our traditionally good franchises, so you never want one of your highlight franchises to go through several years of just being awful. Seen a lot of Henry Ellenson in various sets lately too. Comes up a fair amount. Although usually not autos. I see him a lot as inserts and things like that. I haven't seen a lot of Henry Ellenson autographs, but a lot of Henry Ellenson inserts and things. Yeah, so everything from last night is sorted. Everything from last night is in its shipping envelope along with the stuff from earlier this week. So tomorrow I'm going to print labels for all of that and get that out the door. Knock wood, if nothing out of the ordinary happens anyway. And this stuff, if I have time, I will also get out tomorrow, but I don't know for sure if I will have time because it'll take me a while to sort it. And then, of course, I still have to then get it ready to ship and then print the label and all that. And it generally takes 4 or 5 hours from start to finish, not just obviously for one set of cards, but I mean to do a couple of days worth of breaks usually takes 5 or 6 hours to do the shipping on it. It's just a very cumbersome sort of thing because eBay and PayPal both, their system is so screwed up, they only let you do like X number of labels in the card at a time, and then you can't combine everything unless you go through and do them individually. Like you have to go through by person to combine them, and for shipping, it's just kind of a hot mess the way they have it set up. So it takes longer than it should. To $199 for the Magic Elfrid Payton fabric. So anyway, the point is I don't know that I will get these out tomorrow. The rest of the stuff will go out tomorrow. I will endeavor to get this out tomorrow as well, but I cannot absolutely 100% promise you that it will. I can't even absolutely 100% promise that the other stuff goes out tomorrow, because if something happens to hang me up and I don't have enough time to get all the labels printed, part of it might go and part of it might not, and maybe not all of it does, but my intent is for all of it to go. Because I do have one post office that stays open until 7. So of course that's the one I'm always going to, because yeah. After you get done with, work and everything, try to get everything printed and then run over to the one that stays open until 7, and life is good. It's very, very handy that they stay open late, I will tell you that. So this is box 7 of 8. And even though we probably feel like we have been breaking this for 7.5 days, we're actually probably only about an hour in. Something like that. Maybe not even quite an hour, because I don't know exactly how long those first two breaks took, but probably not more than, I wouldn't think, 20 minutes or something. So we're probably close to being about an hour in on this, in that neighborhood anyway. So not terrible. So later this week, besides replay in basketball, I've got a bunch of Prism up, and it's the super packs. Some of you guys probably broke the super packs with me the last time. Some of you may not have broken them before. But they're basically value packs. Some people call them value packs, some call them rack packs, some call them super packs. But the reason that I personally like to break them is because, in addition to the, what is it, I think, three, four card, or maybe it's four, I don't know. There's three or four retail packs with three or four cards each in those rack packs, value packs, super packs, whatever you want to call them. But also in each one of them are the three red, white, and blue prism parallels, and that's the only place you can get them. Is this going to be another Laker hit? Yes. Kurt Rambis to 199 old school signatures for the Lakers. So we got two old school signatures out of this so far. So yay, I like that. So anyway, yeah, the red, white, and blue prism parallels. I think that's maybe the only place you can get them are in those super pack, value pack, rack pack, whatever you want to call them. So we're gonna do a box of 15-16 this week, and a box of 14-15. And the 14-15 is actually not in a sealed box, but of course the rack packs themselves, value packs, are all sealed, and there's 12 of them, which is what comes in a box anyway. But for whatever reason, they didn't send them to me in a sealed box. They sent them, out loose, which is weird, but whatever. So yeah, so that is coming up this week, and I'm excited about it because some of those red, white, and blue parallels are worth a decent amount of money. Not all of them, of course, but not all of anything is worth a decent amount of money. There's always some worth more than others. Ole Miss 68, Missouri 51. All right. So Missouri is making a little better showing of themselves then. Not down as much as they were. I really can't even remember. Oh, I know what else is. I'm thinking I know I have some more basketball. I couldn't remember what it was. Threads. Yeah, I've got a case of threads from, is it 13, 14, or 14, 15? Might be 14, 15. And threads is another super fun set that sometimes people don't appreciate as much as maybe I do, but you can get some great hits in there. And it has the, well, it has the inserts of like the leather rookies and the wood rookies and stuff like that. But you can find some really cool signatures and material hits in threads. So I'm excited about the case of that. I did also break that up into half case, because it has a decent amount of base in it too, but not nearly to the level of this. Probably like half as many cards per box in that as in this. So it doesn't take quite as long, but it's a super fun set. So I'm looking forward to getting into that this week and into the Prism, and even the replay I'm looking forward to, because some of the replay hits that you can get are bomb hits. Some of them definitely are less than bomb hits, but I think we're gonna hit the bombs. I think we've pulled a hot case, and I think we're gonna have nothing but love flowing out of that case. That's what I'm calling for anyway. Oh, these two are stuck together. I think all the rest of the week we're just gonna pull good stuff. Stuff that everybody wants. Putting that out in the universe right now. Hey, nice. Another preeminent ink for the Celtics, Al Horford. This one 75 of 99. Very nice. Nice, nice, nice. If you're a Celtics fan, you're probably happy with that hit, I hope. I like that hit for you, Celtics fan. Overall, I would say that the second half of this case has been preferable to the first half. So the second half, even though it brought even less bidding interest than the first half did, the hits have been better out of the second half than they were out of the first half, in my opinion anyway. So everybody's got, gonna have their own things that they're looking for, but But we did hit a Sabonis to 10 last night, so that was nice. And we had a couple. I mean, we had some good stuff, but all those stupid reward points replaced like four of our autographs or something. So that made it a little hard to have fun. Here's another freshman fabric for this one for Onowaku for the Rockets, number 20 of 99 for the Houston Rockets. So we probably would have enjoyed the first half a little more had we had more signatures in it and less redemption. I mean, not redemptions, but reward points. Kind of slowed our roll a little bit in the first half of this case. But they did have all those case hits. So there were, I think there were four case hits. I'm fairly sure that there were four that I counted when I was sorting that were case hits. And it was only supposed to be two or three on average. I think two. One each of two different inserts. And we ended up getting four, I think it was, in total. And who knows, we might find another one. 75 of 75 bonus shots insert for the Hawks, that one. So maybe they just didn't do a good job of spreading the love around. I don't know. Or maybe they just figured in those early boxes, hey, we're going to give you extra case hits, so we're going to take away your autograph hits. But yeah. Here's another Ben Simmons, Thomas. Excuse me, just a base rookie it was. Oh, I see Rajon Rondo on the back of that pack. He's been a little difficult to get along with lately, it would seem. He's been bouncing around teams for a bit now, and then got benched in Chicago for running his mouth. I don't know what Rondo's got going on. He's a very talented guy, but I think he must be having some growing pains or something. All right, let's move this stack of base over to the side, and then we will have one box left to blaze through, and we will then do our recap of all of our fabulous hits. We have had some good hits in here. I'm happy with the hits tonight. Hopefully, you guys are happy with what we've hit tonight as well. There's an empty box. Restores my faith and prestige a little. Because after last night, I was feeling very aggravated that we were not pulling what I had expected to pull. So tonight we're pulling more along the lines of what I would have thought that we would get. But, like I said, maybe those case hits make up for it. I don't know. I don't know what those case hits are gonna price when they hit the free market, if they're gonna make up for it or not. They might. And in that case, those guys will be going, yeah, we got the better half of the case. But speaking of case hits, man, I'm still waiting on like a ton of case hits from Absolute. I mean, of my own. Adrian Dantley. I do not know this player. Old school signature to 199 for the Dallas Mavericks. And I'm not familiar with him. So, trying to read the back of it here, see if there's anything I can. I don't know. I don't know when he played. I'm not familiar with the guy, but Dallas Mavericks, hopefully you're familiar with him and hopefully you like him. 'Cause that hit is for you. So you guys want me to keep all of that optic basketball, huh? If I can, as much as I can get, you want me to get it. Am I understanding that correctly? Because I was considering, I mean, I have in an order for, I don't know, I think 4 cases I asked for. And whether or not they'd actually give me 4 cases when it comes time to allocate is another story. But I was considering today either cutting it in half or less. But if you guys are telling me you're excited about it, maybe I won't. Maybe I'll keep it where it is and see how the chips fall and if we end up getting everything that I've asked for. There's a big cat on the back of that pack, Mr. Carl Anthony Towns. Ooh, is this going to be signed? Yeah, Scottie Pippen. Sweet. To 75 for the Chicago Bulls. Mr. Scottie Pippen. I can speak on a good day. Mr. Scottie Pippen. 275 for the Chicago Bulls, and I like that hit too. I like all the distinctive ink and old school ink and all that stuff. And the other part that I like is we're getting hits for a lot of different teams out of this. That again, last night we had a lot of things falling to just a handful of teams. It didn't seem like it was spread around as much. And I think everybody prefers, everybody wants to get a hit. So, unless you're the one getting 5 or 6 hits at a time, then you're like, yeah, it's all me. Send it all my way. But I like for lots of teams to get hits because it's more fun that way for you guys, right? I mean, everybody wants to take home something. Of course, everybody is taking home something out of this with all this base. Yeah, you're definitely bringing some cards back with you. You're gonna have like a pound of cards or something. It's gonna be a lot. You will have a lot to go through when these boxes come, or bags, or mailers, bubble mailers, whatever I'm trying to say. I'll get it out in a minute. I think I did. I have an extra card. No, I guess I didn't. I thought there for a minute I had a card stuck to that card, but apparently I do not. So, oh, there was a Chris Dunn insert. We did pull some Chris Dunn fabric last night, but no Chris Dunn ink. So, have any of you guys gotten any of the case hits from Absolute Basketball? Like, I had the glass hit for Jamal Murray. I have the glass hit for Anthony Davis. I have the glass hit for Scottie Pippen. I haven't gotten any of them. Not a single one of them has been shipped to me yet. I did see today, however, that all of my redemptions for Tyler Ulis shipped out today. I had a Tyler to 25, and I think a couple of Tylers to either 149 or 199 or something like that. I had 3 or 4 Tylers all together, and I saw that all of those shipped today. So maybe they're starting to make some progress on the Absolute Basketball redemptions. But I still have a ton of football redemptions sitting out there too. A lot. Freshman Fabrics 299, 57 of 99 for the Raptors. And I believe he pronounces that Jakob, doesn't he? Jakob Poeltl. So Raptors, there's a nice little rookie fabric hit for you. But yeah, I'll be glad when Panini. I've got so many redemptions sitting in there right now. I'll be kind of happy when some of them start shipping to me. Well, I mean, some did. Tyler Ulis did, but so maybe I should say I'll be happy when they all ship to me because I want them all. I'm tired of waiting on them. I want them to show up. You're waiting on 50. Wow, good gracious. For all from this year, Thomas, or from other years as well? Mine's not 50. I'm probably waiting on maybe 20, 25. I'm not waiting on 50 for sure. If any of yours are older from like, way back, or even any that have been in there for a long time, this year and last year, anything that's been in there for more than 4 months, you can contact them and ask them what's going on with it. And chances are, if it's been in there since last year, it may be something that they never got back from the player or something, and in which case they will work with you to trade you out for another player, somebody else that you like. Well, I've got some DAX, and I don't have a DAC. I've got a Zeke waiting. My Kobe, I got a replacement for. They sent me another Kobe. I had a Kobe number to 25 that, out of innovation, actually, out of the test box I bought of innovation to see if I liked it and wanted to break it. I pulled a Kobe redemption to 25, and they didn't have it in stock anymore, but they subbed it out for me in January and gave me a Kobe to 25 out of momentum. Well, anyway, the older stuff, reach out to them and they will sub players or something or send you a different one of that player if they have it. I do know that they're out of Kobe signatures right now because someone else pulled a Kobe redemption and I had them reach out to Panini this week and Panini told them that they were out of Kobe autographs right now and they would either trade him out for a different player or they would wait for Kobe's to come back in. But anyway, you can go on to Twitter, go to at Panini CSM, and they seem to be honestly pretty backed up right now. Normally they move pretty fast, and I don't think they are right now because I think they're just overwhelmed and maybe even short a person. But that guy is the guy to reach out and speak to, especially anybody that is any redemption that's been sitting in there 4 months or longer. He can trade you out like right away. I had him trade out a bunch of mine, and I just told him any Steelers player, I didn't care what. And he pulled me some really nice Steelers autos and subbed them out for some stuff that was older sitting in my account. So on Twitter at Panini CSM. So first let's go through our inserts. This is a bonus shot number 75 of 75. Kent Bazemore for the Atlanta Hawks. Bonus shot of Jaylen Brown. That one number, I believe it says 30. Does that say 35? I think it says 35 of 75. And that one, of course, for the Celtics. This Sheldon McClellan, this one is number 2 of 5 for the Washington Wizards. So that insert 2 of 5. Tyreek Evans, and that says number 26 of 75. Tyreek Evans for New Orleans. Then for the Kings, this one number 64 of 75. And that's Papagiannis. Now let's take a look at our fabric hits. Freshman Fabrics, 57 of 99 for the Raptors. I believe he pronounces it Jakob. Then Onuwaku, 20 of 99 for the Rockets. Freshman Fabrics. 106 of 199, Elfrid Payton for the Magic. Wade Baldwin IV, Freshman Fabrics, 94 of 99 for the Grizzlies. Bradley Beal for the Wizards, that is something of 199, and I can't quite catch what that first number is, sorry. Something of 199, True Colors, Bradley Beal. You guys can probably see it better than I can. If you've broken with me before, you know I don't have very good middle distance vision, so sometimes I can't see the numbers really greatly. Okay, so this is for the Mavericks. This one is number 5 of 199 fabric. True Colors Justice Winslow. I think that is 181 of 199 for the Miami Heat. And then we have number 61 of 199, Goran Dragic for the Heat as well. And those are our fabric hits. Now let's take a look at our autograph hits. Distinctive Ink, Scottie Pippen, number 5 of 75 for the Bulls. Adrian Dantley, number 199 of 199, I believe that says, for the Mavericks. Old school signatures. Preeminent Ink, Al Horford for the Celtics, that's number 75 of 99. If you can kind of, I sometimes have to get these in just the right light so that you can see the numbering on it. Otherwise, it reflects off oddly and you can't really make it out. Kurt Rambis Old School Signatures for the Lakers. This is 188 of 199. Distinctive ink, Alan Crabb. Crab? I don't know if he says crab or crabby. Crab? Whichever. For the Trailblazers, number 92 of 199, with that excellent signature there that is just an A and a C. My favorite old school signature of the night, and really of the case, probably. Number 18 of 199, Mr. John Stockton for the Jazz. Nice hit, Jazz. I like that a lot. Then we have number 28 of 199, CJ McCollum, also for the Blazers. For the Lakers, Preeminent Ink, number 88 of 99. For the Jazz again, this one is unnumbered. And what was this guy's name? That guy, Balamboy, something thereabouts, also for the Jazz. Stars of the NBA, Paul Gasol, number 22 of 49 for the Spurs. Hit for the Rockets, and that does not appear to be numbered either, that I am seeing anyway. Kyle Wilcher. For the Nuggets, Mr. Jamal Murray does not appear to be numbered. There's the back of that one. Mike Muscala to 199, 93 of 199. And that is also the Hawks. We had another Hawks signature a second ago, didn't we? Or am I crazy? I think we did. Had a Hawks something, anyway. And this is numbered. This one, 4 of 10. You can kind of catch it up there in the corner. I tried to show it to you before, and I don't think I really ever got it to where you could see it very well. But Buddy Hield for New Orleans. Malcolm Brogdon for the Bucks does not appear to be numbered. And then another Preeminent Ink for the Rockets. This is number 11 of 199, Chucky Brown. And that is it for tonight, guys. So thank you everyone for joining. I really appreciate it. I hope to see you again on some other breaks coming up this week, both football and basketball. Got a lot going, so hope to see you again. Thanks, everybody. Have a great night.